couldn't say what I wanted to say. I couldn't do what I wanted to do. And see how the police really did beat me down, I figured I could talk about that. You know what I'm saying? At least talk about how brothers need to start fighting back. So on my new album, which is called Strictly For My Niggas, it's coming out. It should be out now, as a matter of fact. We just talking about fighting back. And instead of talking about what we gonna do if they don't stop kicking our ass, we're talking about what we gonna do this year if they don't watch their back. Because it's like, we had the uprising in Los Angeles. We want to make that like a catch fire type thing where it just reach all over the country. And brothers just start taking shit from these punk motherfuckers and we just start striking back. So hopefully my album could start that in the ways, you know what I'm saying? And also showing that they can't stop rap music and they can't stop no real thug from doing what he want to do. And that's just speaking free. So if it's the take. So I'm from the gutter.
What else?
The gutter.
What about the song of the new station? What's that?
New single, Holla If You Hear Me. It's like saying, like, we tired of this bullshit. Holla if y'all hear me and y'all know it's bullshit. You know what I'm saying? It's like, be like, yeah, you know what's up. Because it's not like, it's not for everybody. It's just for my folks. So it's like, holla if you hear me. That's just some shit the niggas understand. So that's what we holler.
You're also down with
Whatever Nature. Yeah, I'm down with real niggas. Yeah, that's my nigga.
That's my nigga.
Yeah.
I mean, is he doing anything
with
the album?
Yeah, me and Tretch did a song on my album. Me, Tretch, Apache, Big Stretch from the Live Squad, and Madge. We did a song called Five Deadly Venoms. I did a song with Ice Cube and Ice-T called Last Words. So all my real niggas, they came through on this album. That's why it's called Strictly For My Niggas. And Tretch was my nigga, so therefore it was up.
Let's talk about the movie. Yeah, Juice before. That's over with.
Now it's something different. Poetic Justice. Everybody gonna go in there waiting to see Bishop, waiting to see a killer. They gonna come out mad. The whole little movie company, the motherfuckers that did the soundtrack, they fucked me. They was smiling in my face. They ain't know how large the nigga was really gonna be. They thought I was just gonna be an act-ass nigga and that shit. Then they started seeing everybody who they went to go get to be on the soundtrack was my motherfucking nigga. You understand? So they was stuck. Then everywhere they went, I was. Everywhere they was going, I was already motherfucking there. It was hot, so fuck them. That's why we living a thug life. It's a 93 thing. We coming at they motherfucking ass. All black. This year we all black. We ain't fucking with nobody. Fuck y'all. That's how we live.
Well, that's a mouthful. Damn. All right. Well, let's talk about the video. You know, how was it making the video?
It was cool, but like, you know, I did it with like a lot of guns and shit and a lot of shit against the police and my record company and all them, like they cut it, you know what I'm saying? So the video you see on TV ain't the one that I made, so I don't like that video. I'ma say go buy my album, but that ain't my video. That's some shit they concocted to make a nigga be quiet. Cause I was talking about, in my video it's supposed to be niggas shooting the motherfucking police, cause the police be shooting motherfucking niggas. So that's what I was talking about, but they cut it and wouldn't let me do it cause the police run this country. So it's like that.
Well, let's go into that video now. Going to Holla If You Hear Me.
Holla If You Hear Me. And my real niggas, y'all light this motherfucker up this year. That's what time it is.